All right, guys, we are back at it. Still responsibly social distancing. We're walking. We're gonna play 9 holes today at New York Country Club. Mike, do you remember the last time we were here?
Oh yeah, it was wet. It was wet.
How could you forget a day like that? So much better weather today, and we're gonna liven it up and have a little fun with a little side action today, a little side game. We're gonna play Bingo, Bango, Bongo. And for anybody out there who hasn't played it yet, rules are simple. 1 point for bingo, and that's whoever hits the green first. Bango is whoever's closest once all the balls are on the green, and bongo is whoever holes out first. So, those are the rules of bingo, bango, bongo, but we're gonna add a little twist. We're gonna add birdies, a fourth B to this, and we're gonna make birdies 3 points. So 1 point each for bingo, bango, bongo, 3 points for birdies. We're gonna have a little bit of fun with this. Like I said, caught a perfect day. You ready? You wanna take us out?
Let's go.
Take us out. All right, so this first hole, they kick you off with a 500-yard par 5. Pretty much straight out, but tight fairway. Lots of bunkering. In fact, the starter was telling us they had to do away with the black tees, which were all the way back there, because everyone was putting them in the road left. It is very easy to go left here, which is exactly what I did. Hopefully not too far left. I think I hit that first tree on the left and kicked straight down. We're gonna go look for it. See what happens. One thing I will say that I do like, the way that this particular game is structured, it kind of, at first, favors whoever is least long off the tee because they get the first shot at hitting that green for bingo. However, if you're longer off the tee, obviously you've got a little bit of a better chance of putting it closer for the bango. So it favors both. It's kind of, it evens the score a little bit. Depending on if you do or don't have that length off the tee.
All right, thankfully these trees knocked it down right here. Not too bad a shape, but can't get there in 2 from here.
All right, here's the situation I'm in. I got 234 to the front of that pin on a par 5. Normally I wouldn't be going for this. I'm in the rough. That means I got to hit 3 wood out of the rough here, but I want bingo. You're not on the green.
I like it. He's aggressive.
I got you. Look at this shot. Look at this view I got. I mean, how can you not go for it, right?
Uh-oh.
No cut.
It's bouncing around down there by that tree. All right.
111 to the middle.
The rough is a little grown in. Early season rough here, huh?
Some, US Open rough here.
Yeah, but I got a good lie. I'm gonna go with the 48.
Okay.
Come on.
Did he get it?
Work for me.
Oh,
I think he bounced over.
Wow, came out of that hotter than I thought.
Yep.
All right, no bingo.
No bingo yet.
Dude, you bingo from here and I give up. Take the cart path all the way there. Take it all the way there. But I don't know if it was an intentional genius or not that you missed, because he still left himself far enough away that he's still away with an excellent chance at the first bingo of the round.
Purely intentional. Purely intentional.
All right, first bingo. Here we go.
Sure. He tried to get cute with it. Damn it. There's your bingo, folks. There's your bingo.
Got to get it within his ball for the bango. No.
Maybe.
Come on. I think I might be in there.
Oh, it's tape measure.
Tape measure. All right.
I think you're closer.
We have to measure.
Yeah. Yeah, you got me.
I did.
You got me by about 6 inches.
All right, salvage the point here. Yeah, I see you.
Which means I get the first shot at holding.
That's true, you get the first shot at bongo.
They are quick. I will warn you that they are quick.
See how fast they are? You barely touched that.
All right, you're up.
Barely touched it.
got the bongo. You're away.
I'm away.
All right, got two there.
Two double bogeys is certainly not the hottest start, but second round of the year, like I said in the last video, still knocking off the rust. Still feeling a little bit tight in the body from so many months at home. But that's what I like about this side action, is that what normally would be kind of a terrible hole with a couple of double bogeys, we got to have a little bit of fun with it, with those back and forth with the points. So, some points were scored, now we got up ourselves a par 4, 347 yards.
Big stick, huh?
Big stick.
Okay.
Why, is there something out there I don't know about?
You got a lot of water right, so I tend to push those drives right. I'm nervous about it, I'm gonna...
Gotcha.
That's the way the hole turns. So you might be okay as hill. You'll be all right. All right, I used 4 iron off the tee. I wanted to clear this water. Thankfully, I just did, but not much. But I am away. Frank's in the middle of the fairway. He got a nice kick. I am away here for my second shot here, so I do get the first crack at bingo. We're looking at 165 middle. That pin looks like it's front, so it's probably about a 150 shot.
Looks good. Be good. Don't be too long. And there's your bingo, folks.
That looks real good, Frank.
Might be closer, Mike.
You might be closer.
Might be closer.
All right, Frank got the bango. He was on it closer. See me up there. Frank over here. First one to hole out. Let's go.
Been a bit of a disaster putting for me, but we are all square in the bingo bango bongo game right now because Mike just took 2 on that hole and I took 1 point. But here's where it gets interesting. Par 3s is where you really want to have honors because you had that first shot at hitting that green and getting your bingo. So Mike has honors. He's gonna take us out. We've got a 120 yard shot here.
Oh, it's a good looking shot too. Too much?
I hit the 48, I wanted to hit the 52.
Right, aiming for the fat part of the green. Bingo!
Got it.
Bingo!
Oh my God! You almost drained it.
Almost, that was close. Double breaker too, I saw it.
Wow.
That is a tough putt, man.
So you're gonna be in first.
Oh, because I'm still away.
Yeah, so you can pick up your ball.
Right, okay. So I got...
You got bingo, bango, bongo.
That's a three-peat on
the hole?
That's
a three-banger right there. Good for you. All right, we're on the fourth here. Scoring updates.
So it's so funny is that my putting has been a disaster and it worked for me there because I got bingo, bango, bongo because you almost hold that long putt, so I was still away.
There you go, strategy right there.
That's all I had to do. We each had 3 heading into that and I just picked up 3 more.
Okay,
so 6-3,
no birdies yet on the card for anyone.
Nothing on the card, all right.
Got the bingo.
Bingo.
Damn, man.
Saved it from a terrible spot over there.
Good job. All right, so this is why I love bingo, bango, bongo so far, because you don't really have to worry about the score. We're out here trying to hunt those scoring shots, you know? Greens in regulation, closest to the pin, hole outs. You know, it's more fun. We're focusing on the positive stuff, the strong stuff, the good stuff for your game. Score's not meaning much today, right? Score means nothing, right?
It's all back and forth strategy right now.
Strategy. So now I gotta try to tuck mine. I just hit my third shot because I muffed the second. So now we've got 4th shot onto the green, but I could tuck it in close here and try to get a point away from Frank. Let's give it a shot.
think you got it. I think you got it.
All right.
That's a good spot to be in.
Okay, I'll...
Oh. Yet you can still pick up 2 points on this hole by holing this.
Oh, it's needed.
Nice. Nice 2 points there.
Thank you. So guys, New York Country Club, by the way, here in Havistra, New York. When I heard the name New York Country Club last year, 2 years ago when I played the first time, I thought it was a private club, but it's actually semi-private. And as you can see, they're open. So you can get a tee time. Well, it's busy, but you should be able to at least try to get a tee time. It is semi-private, so the public can get out here. So it's a great track. Got to get out here and give it a try. All right, Mike had a great drive here. Just pushed a little bit left. He's got a tree in his way, but he's got a great little 65-yard shot here, chance for a quick bingo if he can get it up and over, let's see. Shied away from the tree a bit. Oh, too much.
All right, took a lot off it.
Too much. What's fortunate for Mike, though, is that he's still away and he could hit any club in his bag and put it on the screen and get a quick bingo.
Oh, I'm putting.
He putt it. Just put it on, take the bingo from me, because I am just over the green here.
Don't be afraid of it.
Easiest bingo you ever made here.
Let's hope.
Okay, you went with the safe bingo play, but gave me an opportunity to get closer.
Yeah, definitely.
I like that play, but it's gonna run, folks.
Look at that.
It's gonna run.
There's no stopping it.
Well, he got the point, though.
Am I closer?
You're closer.
Oh, what did it hit?
Oh, I don't know.
It's like plinko.
The golfer in me wouldn't let me do it, but I wanted to leave that putt just like 6 inches longer than his for like a 2-foot putt to get the be able to putt again and get the point. Couldn't do it.
I only have 139 of that flag, but I got tree trouble, so I'm gonna hit a 7-iron low.
See if we can work that punch fade. What do you think? Punch fade?
Right?
Okay. Went through.
Didn't really punch, but it was fading.
It went through. Would have been nice.
It would have been. Would have, could have, should have. Real good. Bounce left. Members bounce. Little long. Ah, hit the green and bounced over.
Shied away from it on the left side. All right. It's not my shot. Yeah. Not my favorite shot.
All right, I took the bingo, right?
You got the bingo. It's getting late in the match. I got to start playing.
All right, I just picked up a much needed 2 points there because Mike was 2-pointing me to death these last couple holes. So I got the bingo, the bongo, Mike took the bango. Hard to keep track of all these bees. Note one big thing, no birdies out here. Probably because both of our putting has been a disaster, but that's gonna be a big area of focus this year, that's for sure.
Turn a little bit. Oh yeah. Happy with that. I think I'm just off the left side.
got me.
Got you again.
Sometimes it's better to come up just a little bit shorter than the other.
I'm happy with that.
Right.
And I like I was just off the left, like I said. Here we go.
I didn't even see this hole. In fact, I played from that hole all the way up, because why come back over these trees? But
right?
You're about 10 yards shorter, so you get the shot at the bingo right here.
I need this too, and it's not a pretty lie or anything.
Now stay on the green. Now stay on the green. Oh, he went off. Heartbreaker. Heartbreaker. Mine's not exactly a picture-perfect lie here either.
Yeah, that looks tough.
I guess the real cop-out would be to hit it.
That's what I was trying to do.
Here, wouldn't it?
But it's a real cop-out.
It's a real cop-out.
It's got a hole, too.
Oh, come
back. He's off as well. Off as well.
All right, she wasn't off by much, but that's still off. No.
Door open for you big time.
Yep. I tell you why, these greens are scaring us. They're so fast. Couldn't even hold it with a little 60 degree pitch there. Oh. Look at this. Oh my God, you just burned yourself.
Burned myself.
Not only did you not hole out, you're closer than me, so I get the right there. Speaking of social distancing, I was wondering, I'd love to know you guys' thoughts. Leave them in the comments. What's the protocol if you find a couple of golf balls in the woods, the rough, whatever? Are you picking them up? Are we picking them up yet? Or are we leaving everything alone because we're not touching anybody else's golf ball? I don't know. Let me know what you think. All right, let's give a little scoring update here. First, Mike parred that hole. I made 6 because of the fact that I was stuck over here left of the trees with my drive. So he takes the honors back at the perfect time heading into this par 3. That's what you want. You want to tee off first for that bingo attempt. But taking a look here real quick, we got a score tally so far, 12 points for me, 9 for Mike. So Mike, you're 3 points behind. A birdie would bring you right back. All right, what does that say it's playing on your watch?
I have 161. To the middle pin.
161. All right. Oh, I think he's got the bingo, baby. Yeah, he does.
Woo!
That might be a bingo bango.
I needed it.
Get up there, ball. Oh, man.
All right, so for as much fun as we're having playing Bingo Bango Bongo, which looks like it's gonna all of a sudden get to be really tight here. Mike's about to jump up a bunch of points on me, I think. The overall game, just not great right now, but kind of to be expected. Still a lot to work on. I think what's let me down personally this round has been the driver and the flat stick putting. Other than that, I feel like there's been some promise in mid-irons, wedges. I've been really working on that area of my game. But we talked about this on the podcast just recently. We said, this time in the season, when it's been a while since you've been out there, a lot of us have been, you know, home, locked down, not been out there. You gotta take a two-prong approach. You can't just be all one or the other. You can't all be down on your game or up on your game. I think what you gotta do is you gotta find the areas that need improvement to work on. And you also need to celebrate the stuff that's good. Because the good stuff is not only what keeps you coming back, but it's what builds the confidence. So, said this on the podcast the other day, definitely mean it. After each round, it's a good practice to do, and I like to do this, is just to like write down a couple things that were good, a couple things that were bad, 2 columns. The good stuff, that's your confidence builder. The bad stuff, then you know what you gotta work on. Fast greens. Hitting a 60, whereas normally I'd hit a 52, just to get it to stop.
That's a good shot.
Not gonna stop. Not gonna stop. All right. I guess it's good that it rolled off by a foot here.
Strategy play.
Rolled off by a foot, keeps me away. Gives me still that chance for Bango.
Stop right at the hole.
All right, so this could be a big swing here. That was an incredible tee shot. Left yourself about an 8-footer here, a little bit downhill. You got yourself 1 point already. This could be 3 points. 3 points if you hole it.
Yeah, so I'm gonna take a look from a couple of different angles here.
Yeah.
All right, there's no arguing how much better you've played this hole than me. But I can still pick up 2 points.
And I live to another hole.
All right, 9th hole, they call this Heart Attack Hill. Straight up, like you're walking up a ski slope. 325 yard par 4, just all up the hill. In fact, when we were up there at 1, just the expressions on the faces of guys who were coming up 9 were just like huffing and puffing. So if we're huffing and puffing in a few minutes, you know why. But here's a little scoring update. Mike just picked up 2 points. So now he's down 2 points on this last hole. So what do I gotta do? I mean, there's a lot that could happen because of the birdie. The birdie is like, there's almost no mathematical elimination here.
Settle right there.
That's not gonna hurt you.
That's not gonna be terrible. It's open over there.
He got through. All right, guys, getting a little dark out here, first of all. Second of all, came up a little bit short there because I did clip more of that tree than I expected. Just about 40 yards off the green here. Mike thinks he's on the green in his approach, but hasn't been able to confirm it yet. So I want to just put this on the green. If he's off, I get my point.
Is that on?
Yeah, there's a ball right on the green. And there's one short here, hold on.
He's checking.
EVX, baby. Point for me.
Woo. He got the point, ladies and gentlemen.
All right, so I did just put that third shot on, but Mike got up there to the green. We couldn't see anything because we're all walking up this hill. Mike just noticed he's on the green. So he got the point. Who's closer?
What?
Who's closer?
You're not even on yet.
Oh, I'm not on. It rolled back. It's short. Oh, it's just short. Okay. All right. So I got a chance to get a point on.
All right, guys, so here's the deal. I'm on first, so bingo for me, that's a point. I'm only 1 point off of Frank's lead, but he's off the green, he has a chance to put it close. Now, if he gets it, he'll be back up too, mathematically eliminating me, sort of, but we put in that birdie rule for this reason and this reason only. So if I do make this, if he gets that point, then I can get those 3 points and win. That's the only way. But there's a lot that can happen here, so let's see what happens. And the putter gets him there.
Still get the point, even though it's pretty terrible.
All right, Mike needs to make this birdie or he's mathematically eliminated.
If I make the birdie, I win. So, make it I win, miss it I lose. How do you like that?
He likes the pressure.
He eats the slop.
Oh, and he left it on the amateur side.
Ugh.
Oh.
All right.
Oh.
So
actually,
I was away from my gimme.
You were away.
I got the bongo.
So you got the bongo. So you picked up 2 points on this.
But you won the match.
Well done.
Air pound?
Yep. Social distancing.
Nice job, dude.
All right.
Close.
Of course we kept it close. Unfortunately, there were no birdies to be had out there.
Almost.
Yeah, almost. But the final score, 14 to 13.
You got me.
Came down to 1 point, ladies and gentlemen.
But it was fun. It was a different game, a game we haven't played. Love it. Did you guys like it? What other games should we play? Let us know. Comment below, because we love these new games.
That was fun. Yeah. I like that little side game.
What, a little side
action? It kept it interesting.
Yeah, for sure.
Even on the bad holes, it still kept it interesting.
Yeah, for sure.
All right, guys, that was fun. Make sure you leave us a comment. Let us know what you thought. See you guys.